Hello everyone, it's John Cope again from Cope Racing Transmissions and welcome back to our channel. On this particular video, I'm going to let you folks know something about a new package that I put together for you guys. Customers have been requesting this ever since we stopped building transmissions for the general public. We've had customers like, well, I want everything that went in your Super Pro, or I want everything that went in your Pro Race transmission. So what I did was I put together parts packages for the Build It Yourself. I'm calling it the Build It Yourself packages, and they're done in horsepower increments. I started off with 500 and went up to 1,000. And I listed every single piece, every single part that I put in my transmissions when I built them for customers that I included them in a parts package. If you don't feel you have the ability or the time to build your own transmission, what you can do is you could get this kit, the Build It Yourself kit, and take it to someone locally that you trust. A lot of builders that do transmissions for a living, unless they're a Mopar guy, don't have access or don't know where to go or even what to use on 727s, 904s, and 46RE transmissions. So this makes it super easy for them. If you're building the transmission yourself, it makes it super easy for you also. It's the Build It Yourself kit. So let's start off. I gotta get my computer open here so I can tell you folks. If you go to our website, you will see the product categories on the right hand side, and if you scroll down to Build It Yourself kits, you will see the kits for the 727, 904, and 46RE. And I listed them in horsepower applications. And for the 727, just for this video, to be a little bit simpler, I'm just going to talk about one transmission, but the supplies, these kits will have, I'll have kits for the 904 and the 46RE transmissions. I have four kits, a 500 horsepower kit, a 600 horsepower kit, a 700, and then an 8 to 1,000. Now, let's use a little common sense here. If you have 525 horsepower, the 500 horsepower kit will work for you. So what I'm rating the 500 is between 500 to 600 in that area, okay? And on that very first kit, if you got 5 or 5 1/4 or 550 or whatever it may be, and it's a street tire car, then that kit will do you good. But if you plan on running slicks or power adder, then move up to the 600. Okay, it's always better to have a little bit more transmission when you're building transmission to give you that cushion, that safety net. So if you have a 500 horsepower motor and you're driving it on the street, that Build It Yourself kit will work great for you. And I will go through the list of parts that's included in it. But if you're 500 horsepower and you're a little hard on your car, or you're going to put slicks on it, or you tend on racing it, move up to the 600. So you just use a little common sense. Nothing's cut and dry. It's not, you know, just because it's 500 doesn't mean you can't use it on a 400. Or if it's 500, you can't use it if it's 575. I get a lot of people that say that, well, I'm making 5 1/4, I'm making 550. Will that work? Yes, it absolutely will work. So let's right now, let's get into the 500 horsepower kit, and I'll discuss that and what's included in the kit, The pricings will be on the website, so you just go there. So go to our website and then click on the Build It Yourself kits, and then you'll see that they're categorized. 727, 500 horsepower, 727, 600, and so on. So we're going to talk about the 727, 500 horsepower kit. But before I get into what all the kits include, I struggle with it a little bit. I put every single thing in there that I use when I'm building my own transmissions, or when I'm building transmissions for customers, except for the valve bodies, and this is why. A guy with 500 horsepower, he may want an automatic shift valve body, he may want a reverse manual valve body. So it was going to be hard for me to put in the valve body when there's so many different valve body options. A gentleman may want a reverse manual lockup. He may want a trans brake. And then once you start getting the trans brakes, you got all the other options. Clean neutral, first gear launch, second gear launch, you know, lockup trans brakes. So it really, you know, there's a ton of valve bodies that I didn't want to overload, you know, the customer when looking, or you guys when you're looking at the website of, oh my God, well, which kit do I pick? So I kept the kit simple, and the kits don't include the valve body because that's up to the particular driver, builder in this case, of which one he wants. Now, I'm going to make recommendations that the only automatic shift valve body I recommend is in the 500 horsepower range. Anything above that, or in the 550s or close to 600, from there on up, I recommend that you get a reverse manual. Now, when you get a reverse manual, you have your choices of regular reverse manual lockup, which you have to use a lockup transmission, or a trans brake. So that's up to you. So when you go look at these kits, keep in mind when you look at these build it yourself kits, it doesn't include the valve body. So, and I put that on there. So when you want to buy the kit, which it's so easy, just go online. Yes, I'm 500 horsepower. I want that. I want a reverse manual valve body. Are the only two things that you're going to have to order. And I'm going to go over the first kit, the 500 horsepower kit. This is built for your 727 for 500 to 600 horsepower. And this is what the kit includes. This is exactly the parts list that I put in my Pro Street, Pro Race transmissions. Now, the 500 horsepower package doesn't include a billet drum, but the 600 does. So if you have 500 and you want a billet drum, then just go to the 6. But I wanted to have one kit that was economical for people, and so I built this 500 horsepower kit without the billet drum. But this is what the kit includes. This is exactly what I put in the transmissions when I was building them. The kit includes, the build-it-yourself kit includes a complete bushing kit, a complete washer kit. You get a blocker rod for the accumulator. It comes with a billet 4-2 lever, a billet band anchor, and a strut. Is the strut not on here? It is. And it comes with a heavy-duty strut. So, also included is a performance front band and a performance low reverse band. Now, those bands could be in black Kevlar, they could be in red performance lighting. But the reason why I don't list the bands exactly what they are, because the companies that reline the bands, because of COVID, are going through a very, very hard time. So for years, for my entire time I've been building transmissions, I went to one company and had all the bands done. Now it's taken them 4 months to get bands done, which normally would take 2 weeks. So I had to outsource my some of the bands to two other companies. Some of those people do the black Kevlar, some do the green lining. The place in Alabama did the red lining. It's just what these people prefer. So the lining, you know, it's not going to be specific to what it normally always was in the past, only because I have to get bands, I have to get what's out there. Now, they're not stock lining, they're all performance, and I've used all types of these, either in high energy lining, in red lining, in black lining. These are all performance bands that I've used in the past with no issues at all. So don't worry about the type of lining that you get. Like if you call me and say, oh, this is this color, this is that color, they're good to go. So you're going to get the front band, the rear band, a billet low, a low reverse billet servo kit, a 16 element drag sprag, a deep aluminum pan, an oil pan stud kit, and then you're going to get the race kit. The race kit includes my performance clutches, seals, filter, Teflon sealing rings, and a gasket kit. So just to recap, bushings, washers, blocker rod, 4-2 lever, strut, heavy duty strut, the billet band anchor, two bands, a billet servo, a drag sprag. One thing I forgot to mention is you're going to get 15 brand new springs to go in the front drum. That's also in this kit. You're going to get a deep cast aluminum oil pan with a billet filter extension, a stud kit, and then the race overhaul kit. I mean, that's a lot of my kits bundled up in one big do-it-yourself kit. So this one, if you go to our website, you'll see it listed online of everything that's included in it. Here again, doesn't include the Val body. So if you're going to go online and buy these online, buy that and then go to the Val body page and then pick out the Val body that you like, which if you're a girl, you'll get the automatic shift. If you're a boy, you'll get the reverse manual. I'm only teasing. So that's the 500 horsepower kit. Now, it doesn't include a billet steel drum, and I'm a big proponent and put billet steel drums in everything I can, performance, but not everybody can afford one. So this is a complete kit. You have to have a core, and these kits are designs for the guy who's building a tranny. It has nothing. They're going to go out and buy a core. They're like, okay, here's my big black 727. Here's the do-it-yourself kit, and here's the valve body. With those three pieces, you could put the transmission together yourself or take it to a local guy, which I recommend. I'm not going to recommend, some of these larger companies that have complete kits ready to go. So that's the 500 horsepower billet yourself kit. Now I left everything in order so you can compare the 500 versus the 600. So if you look at the parts list, I took the 500 horsepower kit to the 600 and then added a few things to put that there. So I'm going to go to the 600 horsepower kit. Now, the 600 horsepower kit includes everything that the 500 horsepower kit with two more parts. So everything we already talked about is included in the 600 horsepower kit, plus a billet steel front drum with a billet spring retainer and our billet steel planetary with bearings. So you're going to get the billet planetary, and you will have to let me know what year you have. If you go to our planetary tech or our planetary gears on our website. There's a picture on there that shows you which output shaft is for which spline. There's three different splines, and the spline counts are the same, but the pitch of the tooth changes. So the first set of splines is 62 to 75, the second was 76 to 93, then it's 94 and above. And when you're looking at the shaft, there's no way you're going to tell what that pitch is. I can't even tell, but there's identification marks on there to let you know which one you have. So when you buy the 600 horsepower kit and the 7 and the 8 and the 1000, you will have to know what output shaft you have in order to get the correct front planetary. So the 600 horsepower kit is the same as the 5, except the two parts, the billet planetary and the billet steel front drum. And that is rated between 600 to 700 horsepower. You can put slicks on that, you'll be just fine. Now, the 700 to 800 horsepower is a significant jump in price, but it comes with much more included in that kit. So it does include the billet steel drum. Instead of getting just the planetary, the billet front planetary, it includes a planetary kit, which is the billet front planetary with bearings, the front annulus, the rear four pinion aluminum planetary with bearings, a rear roller support, the governor elimination kit, which is that little governor sleeve, and our light and sun shell. So it includes a complete roller package, a complete planetary roller package. It also includes a billet steel rear drum. Once I have guys that are customers or whatnot that are creeping into the 700 horsepower range, I really like to bring that pressures up in the valve body to 200-195. And I found out that the stock rear drums, they don't explode, but because of the increased high pressure, they never saw 200 PSI from the factory. What happens, they just break apart. And it happened to me in my dually. I was just driving along. I had 200 horsepower in there. Or, I'm sorry, 200 PSI pressure valve body in there for about a year. And I just come to the stoplight. I'm sitting there. I just barely give it any gas. And it lost all forward movement. So I brought it back in the shop, pulled it back out. And I come to find out the drum broken too. Which may be more common on diesels and the 48R retransmissions and not so much on the 727s, but it's happened. If you're going to go through the transmission, you might as well put that in there. So the 700-800 horsepower kit over the 600 includes a complete, our CRT complete roller planetary package, a rear billet steel drum, and a set of thick lug racing pump gears. If you're making 700 horsepower, you either boosted or you have a lot of compression. And the stock Chrysler pump gears are known to, when you're going down the track and the gears are driving, being driven one way by the pump, by the torque converter, and then you deaccelerate. Now they're driving, they're on the coast side, and they snap off going through the finish line a lot. So that includes that package. So and here again, you can see everything listed very clearly with pricings on our website at ColtRacingTrans.com. And I'm going to go to the last one. For the 800 to 1000, and again, that really jumps up in price because we're adding billet shafts. So it includes everything in the previous kits, everything that we were just discussing. Instead of you're adding a hardened input shaft and hub, and a hardened output shaft. So this kit doesn't include different ratio planetaries or straight cuts or anything like that. If any one of these kits need to be altered or adjusted, you're going to have to talk to me personally. I really don't want to take nothing off the kits, you know. I already got a deep pan, or I already got this, or I already got that. The whole point of coming up with these kits, the build-it-yourself kits, is for the guy that has nothing. The guy is starting from scratch. He's like, okay, I need a trans. You can get the core, you can get the build-it-yourself kit, and you can get a valve body. On the 1,000 horsepower, 800 to 1,000 build-it-yourself kit, you have so many valve bodies that you can pick from. If you need any advice or anything of picking out a valve body with any of these kits, there goes the phone again, just let me know. All right, so there you have it, the CRT build-it-yourself kits. A customer was asking me for these, so I put it together real quick. They're on the website at coltracingtrans.com under build it yourself. And here again, these kits will work for you. If you don't think you're savvy enough to do a build, or you're afraid of it or whatever, you can still take that kit and find yourself someone with some confidence and some rebuilding skills. I prefer that you go take it to somebody local. If you got any questions, put them down in the comments. Again, thanks for watching. This video will be on YouTube, and it'll also be listed under the Build It Yourself sections of our website. Mopar to you.